The next option, open the standby read-write. And that sounds impossible, doesn't it? But this is what we call a snapshot standby. Now, the snapshot standby capability, it's even better as a cost saver, even better. And as a database administrator as well, I love it. It's wonderful for DBAs. The idea is you take your physical standby database and you open it read-write. Now, while it's open read-write, to end users, it appears to be an absolutely normal open database. What do you use it for? You could run queries against it, but perhaps more commonly, you'd use it as your test system, your development system, your UAT, user acceptance testing system, anything you want. Now, for example, you could open the standby as a snapshot standby, deploy a whole new application release to it, do all the testing you want, including using things like your AWR reports, database replay, do anything you want in it, with the absolute certainty that the database is a real recent clone of production, as up-to-date as the point at which you opened it read-write. Now, while you're using it for developments and so on, redo is still being received. Redo is still being written from the primary by LNS to RFS and written standby logs. Redo is being archived. So recoverability is not compromised. And you can open it in this fashion for a week, maybe. You probably wouldn't want to do it for a month, but you can open it for a long period. So you open it read-write, do whatever you want to it, and then when you've done your testing, tested your application release, done whatever it may be, done all your development work, then we resynchronize it for the primary. The enabling technology, by the way, is one has to set up flashback database to flash back to the point at which it was opened, and then all the backed up redo, all the redo that's been received and not applied, gets applied. So there is absolutely no compromise to recoverability. Now, how do you do it? Right, well, here's my database. Well, yeah, this thing right now, this is open, isn't it? So I'll need to close it at this point, so I'll give this a shutdown immediate. Oops, connect slash assist DBA. Because it was opened read-only, I will have to shut down. But note throughout this, I'm working on the standby at this point. There's no downtime on the primary at all at this stage, and then I'll start it up in mount mode. And once it comes up in mount mode, I want to make sure it is in fact synchronized with the primary. So my primary database, oh, there we are, is, okay, so I'll, right, I'll start a managed recovery process. So my primary, oh, I'm just looking in these queries at the log switch sequence number of the block. I could equally well look at the system change number. That would be another way of proving that we're synchronized. So we're now applying 29 block 5611. We're very nearly up to date. And right now, I'm pretty sure we'll have caught up. Now, force a log switch. To make sure we really are synchronized. And we are now receiving the log number 30. Right, how do I open it read-write? Well, what we do is we begin by cancelling the managed recovery. hit cancel the recovery, then just one command, and that command is alter database, convert to snapshot standby. This process we would normally automate, by the way. And if we now look at what's happening within this database, archiver, closing it off, good. And look at the views, you'll see that still in mount mode. Then we alter database open. Now previously when I opened the database, of course, it was opening read write. But this is now, previously was opening read only, I should say. This time it's going to open read write. It's open read write. Oracle is aware of what's going to happen, of what's going on, however. If I look at the database role, Oracle knows that it is theoretically still a standby database. So the redo is still being received. It simply isn't being replied. And this is an absolutely normal read-write database. I can select star from scott.dept. Of course I can. I can delete from scott.emp. I can commit. So I can do anything I want on this thing. Absolutely, as far as users are concerned, it's an absolutely normal read-write database. It will be generating AWR snapshots. I can generate ADDM reports. I can tune my SQL. I can run workload tests. I can deploy whole new applications, create new users, drop schemas. I can do anything at all that I like, that I want to this database. And having done all my work, right, I try to emp and that thing is there. I can even drop the table. Drop table, scott.emp. And that table is gone, as far as this database is concerned. A week later, maybe, I've completed my test run. So what do I do next? Well, terminate the instance. Just abort it. There's no particular need to be nice by using a shutdown immediate, because I'm going to throw away all the work I've done. Then mount it. Start up mount. Note that throughout this whole process, of course, the primary is running exactly as normal. There's no downtime at all on the primary. Yes, Dave?
Yes. Where are the redo logs created or written when the database is a snapshot standby?
In this particular case, I've configured my databases in the simplest way possible. And if you look at it, show parameter, I'm going to Madrid, my spare standby at this point. Show parameter log archive dest. I've set it up in the easiest way possible, in that I've set up, in fact I haven't set up, I'm relying completely on defaults. Yes, if we look at it, so it's too late to show you, but if you look at the archive log list, by connect slash assist DBA, by default, they go to the flash recovery area, or fast recovery area, I should call it. And what will be happening in the fast recovery area is there will have been, all the time that it was open as a snapshot standby, to that fast recovery area, there will have been two streams of redo written. There will have been the redo generated from the primary via standby logs, and the redo generated by the database Berlin, because it was an open database. And to lead on from that question, when you open your snapshot standby, because remember, it was open as a normal read-write database. It was generating its own redo, so it was in fact archiving two streams of redo. The redo received from the London primary, and the redo generated by the Berlin snapshot standby. And I didn't configure it other than just default, go to the fast recovery area. On a production system, we would be a bit cleverer than that, and we would direct the redo from the primary and the redo from the snapshot in a more intelligent fashion than that. But it was a good question. I should have emphasized that. There were two streams of redo being generated while the thing was open read write. So
Great. One more question, John. If we open the physical standby in write mode, then can we bring it back to mount mode and receive changes from the primary and apply them?
That's what I'm at right now. So I've shut it down. I've started in mount mode. One more command. If I can. And the next command, convert to physical standby. This is the conversion back. Quite a lot is going on at this point. At this point, we are using the flashback database facility to flash back the database to the exact system change number at which I opened it. So we're, in effect, backing out all the changes I did. But the backout, of course, is done through the flashback database mechanism, which is extremely fast and efficient. So we're reversing the database back to when it was a true physical standby. And the proof of that, have to restart it. It's quite a dramatic change because this does convert the control file as well as backing out the database. So I'll terminate the instance and mount it again. We would, of course, automate all this in any sort of production configuration. I must emphasize that throughout this whole process, my primary stays running, and there is no break or minimal break in the transmission and reception of redo. I guess there will be a few seconds during this process when redo is not in fact being received. Right, so having remounted, it's now back to a normal physical standby. So what do I do next? I start the recovery. And at this point, it will be applying all the redo that was received and archived from the primary during the period that it was open as a snapshot standby. And within, well, if it had been opened as a snapshot standby for a week, it's going to take a while to catch up. But there is no compromise to recoverability. All the data was there. And we can see, note, I dropped a table at that point. But well, I'll need to, so I haven't opened it read-only, but if I recover manage standby database cancel, if I now open the database read-only, alter database open, I no longer have to specify read-only. I did back with 8i, but current release Oracle is, of course, intelligent enough to know that. And we see everything's there. So I've now, in effect, thrown away the week's worth of work and applied any changes that have been done on the primary in the meantime period, in the meantime. And this is a truly wonderful capability. What does it do? It saves you on a license footprint, clearly, because I've now got one system that's been used for all my test or development work, and at the same time, it's given me 100% recoverability in the case of disaster. From the DBA's point of view, it's really productive. It saves me as a DBA the hassle of continually having to clone test and development systems from production. It's a really powerful capability.